Confirming 20.
Good, sir. Good luck.
Thanks.
Release in 3, 2, 1. Upside down.
Hey, Ethan. You know that this view is one of my favorite things about being a pilot. Thought you weren't going to be on station until later today.
You know better than anyone that flying faster than regulation speed is one of my favorite things.
True. So who do I need to get fired for letting you in comms?
That information is classified. But I've got an appointment with her when we get back from our mission.
One of the benefits of being a famous pilot?
Yeah. By the way, here's your flight plan. Where do you see the alien ship with your own eyes? The vids they've been showing? Don't do it justice.
Whoa. How big is this thing?
It's big. Watch out for secondaries from the alien vessel. Their activity back and forth from the surface has been increasing. CNC is still trying to figure out why.
Copy that. Starting my... Whoa.
Watching, could you do me a personal favor? Straighten out your shuttle and try not to hit the large alien ship. So, I haven't got the wedding announcement yet. Getting cold feet or finally wising up?
Hey, lay off, Ethan. Not all of us want to be celebrity swingers.
Yeah, I know. Wow. Looks like they're sending off another salvo of those pod things. Wonder what they're for. Channel 6 says they contain scanning and storage devices. Looks like we've been visited by a bunch of alien voyeurs. Yeah, well, whatever they are, they make their ships big.
This is Lieutenant Gavin Insong with Lorien Security. We're sending out a wideband roll scan to your onboard navcom. Please set your receivers to accept.
Wow, these new visitors have the brass wound pretty tight. It almost makes me miss wartime. At least then we knew what we were dealing with.
I said cut the chatter. Further violations will result in the suspension of your charters. Shuttle 329, we need you to enter a final approach vector and dock. We even lit up the hangar for you. That's right, you found it. Give that kid a prize. Just bring it in nice.
Has separated with platinum-selling pop star Jasmine Taro after a whirlwind 5-month romance. While Taro's agent has no comment on the recent split up, Wyeth was overheard saying that he found the million-selling diva to be obsessive and clingy. Our red carpet correspondent Cynthia Shales has more on it. Sources say that famed war hero and celebrated.
Hey, little brother. What took you so long?
Ethan.
I hope you're thirsty.
Why?
Because you're dumb and ugly. But I can do something about thirsty. So, what do you have?
I need something fresh. Something with flavor.
A good flavor? Or just a strong flavor?
Good and strong.
Just good. We're both designated drivers.
I can't believe they held up the mission for me.
No, they didn't. It took 3 days to do a complete language dump.
A what?
They have a computer that translates. So, we sent them everything ever written in our language so it could learn.
Everything? Doesn't that tell them dangerous things? Like our level of technology?
Their technology is so far ahead of ours, it doesn't matter. If they want to destroy us, we can't stop them.
So what about us? Do we get to go aboard the alien ship?
They better not try to keep us off the first alien ship to visit Edomea.
Unless the legends are true, and Adagio really was destroyed by aliens.
There was never a planet called Adagio, so we're not from it. Good job. Not much dribbling.
It's nice to drink something that wasn't generated from sewage.
What do you think all those fresh fruits grow in?
Oh, excuse me. I thought you were some other war hero, suck up, brother.
I think he wants a fight.
Yeah? Let's see what you got.
Gideon, the co-pilot of the first alien contact party can't go starting a barroom brawl.
You're sure about that?
Yeah. That's the pilot's job.
Gideon Wyeth, what are you doing?
Olivia! I'm helping some Marines with their combat training.
You're getting your uniform all dirty.
These guys keep rubbing their blood all over it.
This has gone on long enough. Now they're getting my clothes dirty.
Excuse me, Mom, but I can't kill him if you're in the way.
Excuse me, then. I'll move. You see, Gideon, you just have to know how to talk to them. Did I hurt you? Good. You're both so stupid. Getting into a fight when you're on the verge of the most important mission in history. You're due for pre-flight briefing in 10 minutes. But were you coming to look for your fiancé? No. You were making kissy-kissy with a bunch of Marines.
That doesn't mean I love you any less, Olivia.
Yeah, well, he did it for you.
Oh? What? One of them insulted me?
They didn't mention you. Naturally, you had to beat him up.
I'm still mad at you. When you finish your briefing, I'll be in my lab.
I've got a couple of things to do before the briefing. I'll meet you at mission prep.
Captain Wyeth, your brother isn't in the briefing room yet, and I was told to give you a quick refresher on sidearms use.
I've already been trained.
You've been trained in hand-to-hand combat too, but it looks like you forgot a lot.
Good work, Gideon.
The game was rigged!
It's always rigged against grunts like us, bud. Get used to it.
Maybe there's a reason I'm an officer and you're not.
I'm sick of emos like you showing no respect for the soldiers that do all the grunt work.
Hey, lose the pistol.
This isn't the time, bud.
Everybody drop your weapons. Nobody go anywhere. MPs are on their way.
Hey, thanks for not offering them.
He gets crazy sometimes, but he's not a bad guy.
We won't let him try anything again.
If he does, I'll kill him.
We've seen the vid on this. Clear case of assault. This boy's going into the brig for a few years, and he's never going to go into space again.
Good Marine, stupid guy.
The only stupid guy here is my brother.
Look, I thought I could stop him without killing him. It was my call, and I was right.
Yeah, this time.
Attention. You can come in now, Ambassador Lanwell.
Thank you, Major.
My men will have this under control, but we don't know what to expect. I want you properly armed. This is the Haze Blaster. It's still in prototype, but these have been tested, and they work. If things go wrong, our assignment is to protect the Ambassador. Your assignment is to return to the ship and get it ready for takeoff.
Thank you.
Shubes Kovane, Disbik Mazan. Agak Bazis.
Here, you put it in your ear. You're expendable.
Thanks. Gideon used to put shiny things in his ear when he was a baby, too.
Okay, that doesn't feel good. It's taking root.
This is what's it say? Now, do you understand me?
Yes, I do.
What's she saying?
It's the universal translator. It's painless.
Sisters and brothers, prepare yourselves. What we have searched for so long, we now will see. Please beg the glorious human visitors to enter. We've searched a long time. Many lifetimes our people have looked for you. Glorious humans, survivors.
Kalem, you are proven right, though I doubt it. These appear to be humans.
Please, don't kneel to us. It's wrong.
We came in hope to save you from the Seekers, but we failed.
The Seekers?
Those who destroyed your ancient homeworld.
We thought our voyage was secret, but as soon as we received your broadcast signals, someone on our ship sent a message capsule. Now, they will come, and this time, they will leave no survivors.
How long do we have?
Maybe 2 days, probably less.
2 days? What can we do in 2 days?
This is a great tragedy. You will all be killed.
What kind of weapons will they be using?
They throw rocks.
Rocks? They throw rocks?
Asteroids.
If there's nothing we can do, then why did you come?
Gideon, you're not the ambassador.
If there's nothing we can do, then why did you come?
The Aurelian people are ashamed to have brought such calamity upon glorious humans. We pray to all the gods that some of you survive.
How? How will we survive?
I promise all that we can do to help human survivors, we will do.
On the whole, I'd say that went pretty well. Apart from finding out that the human race is doomed, everybody was polite, and they were really apologetic about getting us all wiped out.
We're not wiped out yet. We have weapons.
Our ships have the power to blast small asteroids out of the way.
That's better than nothing.
It is nothing.
Look, we're not going down without a fight.
May all your enemies lose their way.
It will be a great victory if any humans survive.
So much for 2 days. Time to abandon the ship!
No way! They're blowing up the escape capsules anyway. We might as well just stick with the ship.
We're a big fat target, and half the maneuvering rockets aren't responding.
So it'll be an ugly landing.
You're the expert on ugly landings. You take us in.
Are you all right?
I have a heartbeat. And my right knee won't hold me.
I've got you. Come on.
That was the lousiest landing I've ever seen.
Give me your weapon.
That's your plan? Give the gun to the cripple?
Look, I'm a better shot. You're too busy helping me walk.
Someday you're gonna trust me.
Come on, let's move.
everybody else in there with the Seekers.
And how many of them do you think we're gonna get out of there alive?
Doesn't look like Olivia's here.
I'll stay here and help protect the pods. You go get Olivia.
No, Ethan. You go now. Separate pods.
Don't be stupid. I can't trust these guys to hold a pod for you. Now hurry.
Wish me luck.
Wait. You'll need this more than I will. Find Olivia and get back fast.
Egan, is Olivia still down in the science center?
They're scanning everybody. They're taking most of the scientists.
But Olivia, is she?
I haven't seen her. But if she's there, she's in trouble.
Are there any escape pods left?
Lots. Go for it. Hey, Gorgeous.
You shouldn't have come back for me. We'll never make it to the escape pods from here.
Don't worry. Ethan is holding one for us. Better go back into that room.
Where are the soldiers I left here?
I killed them.
Why don't you little worms give up and die?
And miss the chance to kill monsters like you?
Yes. I'm a monster. The only question now. Do I kill you quickly, or do I pull you apart with my bare hands?
When the station burns up on re-entry.
Gideon! You found her!
Ethan! You're not dead!
Not for lack of trying. Get her into a pod.
I can run it alone.
Shooting gallery between here and the pods. I have to be with you to cover you.
So take her and go.
Help your brother.
Let me look around, see if there's anything here we can use. Oh, man.
They're not gonna bother with us, are they?
Yes, they are.
Thank you.
You two were the only ones on that pod?
Yes, sir. We were with Ambassador Landwell. My brother was the pilot.
You were with Ambassador Landwell's party? Your brother is Ethan Wyeth?
Was. They got him as our pod took off.
I'm sorry, man.
We've got to get Olivia to a doctor. She got shot just as we were boarding the pod.
We're not far from a hardened underground base. We can send her in one of the sides, and I'll take you and...
I'm staying with her.
I'll be fine, Gideon. Go with him.
Hey, Flyboy! Are you coming or are you waiting to catch a plane?
I'm gonna try to avoid those from now on. You guys mind if I drive?
This guy's got some balls. Let's go, Paulson. Corporal wants us at ComSense Stat.
Wait, you guys headed over to the command center? Supposed to meet Admiral Torn there.
Whoa. You Wyeth?
Yeah.
Hop in, sir. There's a general call out to bring you in. My apologies for the...
Don't worry about it, soldier. We flyboys tend to deserve our reputation as jerks.
Yes?
Sir, Captain Gideon Wyeth, reporting.
Gideon Wyeth? Thought we had his brother. I must say I'm fairly surprised to see you here in one piece. Sounds like you've had an interesting trip through high orbit to get here. We'll have to discuss that sometime.
Yes, sir.
For now, I need to know who these bastards are and what they want. The few reports I was able to pick up from Lurian before she fell are sketchy at best. They've hit every major population center, every military base site. We've never seen this kind of military power before. You were on the ambassadorial shuttle, right, Captain?
Yes, sir. The species we met with seemed to be...
Species? So the reports of this being an entirely different group of buggers are true?
Yes, sir. This new element seems to be concerned with some sort of scanning of the human brain. It appears that they're searching for something. I witnessed multiple... targets. Both military and civilian summarily executed following the scanning.
Searching for something. Some of my advisors have put that idea forward as well. Have you seen them take any prisoners?
General, sir. Priority line from Deep 4. Wideband coded urgent, sir.
Thanks, Private. This is Torn. Yes, that would explain the withdrawal, sir. But what about our ballistic... all gone? Yes, sir. Thank you. I suggest you find a way off-planet as soon as you can, son.
Sir?
I'm telling you now before the panic starts. Find a ship. The sirens will be starting shortly.
But what about you, sir? Can I...
I'll be staying here, Captain. This is going to be something to see. Really something.
Thank you.
There's a civilian airstrip just north of the med labs.
Where do you think you're going?
Hey! We need to get out of here.
Who doesn't? Ask him if we have any room.
You don't understand. We were on the alien contact ship. We have information that may be crucial to the survival.
How do I know you're not lying to try and grab my ship like these jerks?
Listen!
Please, forgive his excitement. Captain Steele. Captain Marin Steele.
Captain Steele, what he was saying is true. We were both stationed on Lurium and have vital information that we...
So who are you?
I'm Dr. Olivia Morgan, and...
You're a doctor?
Yes, I am.
What about him?
My name's Gideon Wyeth, and I...
He's a pilot.
Well, why didn't you say something earlier, Mr. Wyeth? With all the flak coming down, I could use someone who can handle dorsal cannons in a dogfight. Come on, then. I'm just about finished flight prep. Do you think you can handle keeping our boarding ramp free from any more uninvited visitors? Channels.
Be advised, we are tracking something different. This thing is huge and coming in even faster than the others. Report to evacuation points immediately.
Okay, we need to get in touch with any other ships that made it past. Can we do that? Is anyone there? Can someone hear me? What's going on? Is our comm unit busted? I wonder if the shock from the...
Hold on! Go back. I think I can tell what they're saying.
What?
Remember the worm in his ear that I mentioned earlier? Apparently, it's a sophisticated universal translator that's loosely related to the common sea slug. What are they saying, Gideon?
It's a call. A plea for any surviving human ships. They offer assistance and they want to...
Assistance? You can't be serious.
No. These are the first beings that we met with. They're friendly. Almost too friendly. We were welcomed onto their ship like gods. I think they were trying to warn us of the attack.
So, I'm supposed to believe that there are not only one, but two advanced alien species out there with a simultaneous interest in little old Edomea. I mean, millions of years go by without so much as a hello there from the great beyond, and for some reason, they both picked today to come out of the closet?
They're aliens. Our first contacts. We're trying to get here first to warn us.
Nice timing.
And now they may be our only chance of surviving. How many days worth of O2 does this ship hold? You think we have enough fuel to find a habitable planet in the next star system over?
You're asking me to trust an impression you got from a handshake.
Captain, listen to the comm. The rest of the bands are silent. There's no one else out there.
Call your friends, Gideon.
Greetings, Exalted Ones. Our supply of translation implants was lost aboard the mothership, so we pray gesture will suffice.
Sir, I was on the diplomatic shuttle and was able to get one before all hell broke loose.
Interesting. Our joy in this association can only be overshadowed by the monstrous tragedy you have suffered.
The Ankul, the beings who savaged your world. They prefer the benevolent title of Seeker. It is a term which the civilized universe has never been able to see past.
Until now, when the Galactic Senate hears of this, that our long-held suspicions are true.
Patience, my friend. We will deal with further strategies when we reach Aurelia. Until then, we have honored guests hungry for comfort and truth. I imagined you would eventually find me here.
Earlier you mentioned something. Something about hidden powers?
I am a remnant of the ancient religion, human. All of the civilized races have individuals with the seeds of this power. Our prophecies say that the humans are the originators and the masters, and that through them, our own shall blossom.
Do you have this gift?
I do, human. It is my hope that with it, I can kindle something inside of you.
Well, I've never been any good at magic tricks.
Oh no, human. This is something far greater than any trick. This is your purpose, and it courses through every cell of your body.
Okay, so what can you do? With this power, I mean.
Gideon, this is the sum total of a being's undeniable confidence, a power which, if harnessed, can bend all the energy of the stars to your disposal.
So this power is a weapon?
Interesting that you would infer that. So, the human would have me teach him?
Hold on. I'm not a believer yet.
Very well. See the shell here on the table in front of you? Watch. Never been able to sustain it for so long. Are the sayings true?
Sayings? Hey, how are you?
And through their presence shall all be made strong.
Thank you.
Good timing. Looks like we're about to come out of hyperspace.
See before you my homeworld, exalted ones. The famed beauty of the undying seas await us.
Commander, Seeker Destroyer off starboard. They're charging weapons.
This cannot be! We'll never stand a chance against that kind of firepower.
Saran, bring us inside their firing radius.
Get me close enough to smell the dirty beasts.
All crew are ordered to don their vacuum gear and abandon ship. My brave warriors, what lays ahead may be the deadliest challenge of your lives. Our foe has gone unchallenged and unbeaten for centuries. It is my hope that this assault will find them overconfident and unprepared.
There's nothing we can do.
won't let their sacrifice be in vain. My son, my son. This is not easy, Exalted One, and I fear we are not through with such tragedies until our goal is met. But our fiery entry into Aurelia's skies did not go unnoticed, and this beach will soon be crawling with seekers. We must put aside our grief for the moment, and focus on survival.
Can we not give them a moment, Anorum? They have lost so much.
I can only dare to imagine their pain, Wise One. But my duty is to preserve their lives. We must get off this beach and out of sight before their scouts arrive.
I know I'm not the only one who suffered loss today. So we need to get away from the crash site, away and into cover. Anorum, where can we go until we figure out what to do next?
The city of Arnis lies on the other side of this canyon, Exalted One. There we will find protection and brave allies.
I'm sick of people dying for me.
And so, our suspicions were once again proven true, my fellow council members. It's now beyond doubt. The Enkol, the Seekers, have a dark, murderous face that Galactic Society has never seen. We find that they have been stabbing at the very heart of our most deeply held faith. These four-legged charlatans must be exposed.
Charlatans? What an interesting label you would so dismissively toss at the beings who have freely given us the resources to build the very structure you stand in today.
Who's this guy?
Counselor Sivan. He's from the northern archipelago.
Looks like he's got an icicle shoved up his...
Very observant, Exalted One. Counselor Sivan is our ambassador with the planet side, Enkol.
Maybe they put the icicle there.
Please, Exalted One, do not make me regret giving you a translator.
Our race, Counselor, has been in indentured servitude for 1,000 years for it.
Exactly. 10 centuries of labor given faithfully through blood and tears into your suspicious hands. And you would throw it to the wind based on your feeble suspicions and nightmares?
We are no longer talking of suspicion and nightmares, Sivan. We are talking about the mass murder of an entire people.
Our seeker benefactors have the power to grind us back into the puddles our ancestors crawled from. And you think it wise to turn and challenge them at the very cusp of our freedom?
You seem to have become something very different from the rest of us, Sivan. Something very different indeed. And as for your animal suspicions, I have something here that you might find interesting. Or someone. Anorum, if you will.
This council meeting is over. The council is to dissolve their membership, and any submissions they may have offered are to be held.
How dare you! This is a planetary ruling council! You are in breach of galactic law! And when the Senate hears of this...
Enough! You pathetic worms have gone too far.
Now we see the true face of our masters.
Seal off this chamber. The rest of you can start the cleansing.
You foul monsters! You want blood? Come and taste mine!
No!
Human, stop! You do not realize that I am on your side.
My side? What do you mean you're on my side?
There are those who will want to meet you. Powerful beings who can open up unlimited avenues of possibility for one like yourself.
What powerful beings?
Hold still. Hold still or I'll skin you alive. I can see now why they were worried. I had hoped to take you alive. I've never seen a bounty this high. Even your corpse will buy a new world.
It should now be plain to all gathered here that the Seeker threat is real and pressing. We must take the fight to them. As long as they have the faster-than-light communication capability of their Ansible Tower, they will be pulling all of their forces to defend Enkull's strong points and hold out until their homeworld reinforcements arrive. If the main Seeker armada turns its eye upon our little world, my brethren, we will surely suffer the same fate as thousands of worlds before us. We need to make sure they never do. Our spies have successfully sabotaged the Ansible. We need to strike hard and fast and take the capability out of their hands permanently. We will be inserted into a valley south of the Ansible. From there, we will move through the tunnels until we reach the Temple Annex. This plan depends on our stealth and speed to be successful. The Aurelian fleet should be overhead shortly after we have the cannons in our possession. We will be outnumbered and outgunned, my brethren. Charge your weapons and ready your blades.
What's wrong? Forget where the trigger is?
You know, it just occurred to me that this is the only thing I have left from home.
You mean you forgot to pack underwear? Hey, I was just kidding. Your underwear is your own business.
You can't come on this mission, Marin.
Oh, yes I can.
Let me explain. There's nothing left of our world. Nothing left of humanity. To venture out on a ridiculously dangerous mission with both of us? I don't know what I was thinking. If I lost you, I mean, if either of us were lost.
Gideon, Wait, why should you get to stay? I've got way more experience than you.
If things go bad here, one of us needs to find a way to get past the Seeker Armada and stand before the Galactic Senate. The Seekers need to be unmasked. Humanity's voice must be heard. If I fail, if we can't shut down this Ansible, then you're humanity's last hope.
Okay, you've made your point.
What is the delay, Exalted Ones?
Dad grounded me.
What she means to say is that after some consideration, Marin will return to Arnis with the dropship.
I am relieved by the wisdom displayed by the Exalted.
Commander, the enemy sentries are swinging back towards our location. We must move now.
There has been a change of plan, Banneth. You are to take two of your phyletic guard and escort this Exalted One back to Arnis. There you will keep her under close guard until this mission is fulfilled.
But, Commander, this mission is already a long shot. To cripple ourselves from the onset by losing three of our best?
I have given you a command, Banneth. This outburst is beneath your discipline. Call your guard and move on my orders now! He is my fiercest warrior and most able captain. Forgive his passion, Exalted Ones, for therein lies his greatest strength. Our troops are prepared. Now we must move. Farewell, Exalted One.
Commander, the pod
target's operational. I repeat, the target is operational.
Our data indicated that it would be another day until the Ansible was functional.
The Ansible is fully recovered from our earlier attack and is currently charging for an emission. Agent 2 reports that Ambassador Cachel is en route for the Rault.
This message must not be sent.
Yes, Commander. Hold on. I'm receiving multiple incoming... No!
Akale, report! Akale, what is your status?
Sir,
our plans have changed. The Ansible must be taken down, or all the wrath of the Encalamata will descend upon our world. The Seeker artillery must be in our hands before the fleet arrives. I will take Sarkin with me into the tower. Danos, you will lead the remainder of the squad through the Temple Annex.
There are several new patrols guarding the entrance to the temple. We must take these patrols quickly and leave no survivors to warn the base. Our goal is at the other end of this valley.
Guys, you know, shouldn't we be...
A moment, human. This place is sacred to us. The Seekers made a grave error in building their fortress on an Aurelian holy site.
Kay.
Make no mistake, human. This was a deliberate and intended slight. It is common Seeker strategy to demoralize an indentured people by turning their most treasured sites into Seeker fortresses. The Bridge of Eridan has held 10,000 years, human. It will hold for a little longer.
This incursion ends here.
Human, if we can just break through and put those doors on our back, we might be able to stem this tide.
Surrender, filth! Surrender and die!
What is this?
This is the hope of Aurelia, human. All that we see is noble and good and pure. All that we aspire to is held in that symbol. It is held in you.
I never understood.
It is a heavy weight you carry. Epochs of history, the tides of war, the blood of nations, all of this is laid at your feet.
But I... how can I possibly be held to... I mean, it's not...
It is not easy being God. Seekers circle around the bridge.
Yes. Yes, let's go.
We need to get that grate open.
Stand back.
I had not realized the conveniences accompanied with deity.
Ugh. I'm gonna feel that one in the morning.
This door will not open unless we trigger the release switch.
I'll get it. Where's the switch?
Down there. You are brave, human.
Gotten word of what happened? She'll want to hear about the ridiculously flawless victory we pulled off without her.
The Exalted One will delight in relaying his heroism, it would appear.
Come on, Enorm. Is it wrong for me to be excited about overcoming incredible odds and defeating an enemy who's not only evil, but annoyingly smug?
Well, no, Exalted One, but...
And doing it with such style!
Now I suspect that it is my translator that is malfunctioning. Baneth, my friend, can you connect me to the Council? Our next steps will need to be taken swiftly.
Commander, I'm getting word from the capital. There has been a coup.
A coup? But who would do this? I thought we had routed out all of the opposition.
Did Sivan have any other admirers? He seemed like the type who would surround himself with other types.
With true Aurelians, who don't want the blood of our people shed in vain. I will not see our millennial debt spurned.
You do not know what you do. If we fail to move quickly on the Seeker forces scattered around the planet, they will be able to organize and keep us off balance until their off-world fleets arrive. You are condemning our world to annihilation.
No, Commander. You did that. By willfully challenging our rightful patrons with your embarrassing accusations. You have forced our hand, Commander. And we can only hope to pull something from the ashes by giving you and your conspirators to the Seekers. With our deepest apologies.
And you really think that your loving patrons will let this go with a slap on the wrist? I've seen what these bastards do to worlds they don't like. They erase them.
Be enough from you! I always found the old religion to be tiresome.
Baneth, thus you seal your doom.
So now it becomes painfully obvious that this traitor has sold our centuries of labor and trust for what? For a myth? Will the destruction of our world, the wholesale eradication of our race, be worth the discovery of these hairy little primates in our...
You irreverent fools. You become one of them, haven't you? Have you not seen what these humans are capable of? The Seekers are killing them because they are terrified of the powers they possess.
If these humans are so amazingly powerful, Lysenor, then why are they practically extinct?
This debate is pointless, Sivan. None of us here belong to the old faith. The few members of the Council who did left when the coup began. We're not here to validate the deity of these humans. Let us get this sentencing over with and move on.
Yes. What has been the Seeker response to the coup?
The Seekers vow that their response will be measured. As long as we deliver the rest of the Magesco party, as we take them into custody.
The rest?
We have already delivered one of your Exalted Ones into their hands. The other will be there shortly.
This ends now.
You! The troglodyte dares intrude upon our deliberations!
It appears a blow to the head was not enough to teach you proper etiquette, human. Perhaps something more direct is required.
Where is Marin?
Your female is safe. We had to make a trade for the survival of our world. The Seekers would accept nothing else.
Exalted One, we must go. I know where the Enko will be holding Marin. If you wish to live long enough to save her, we must go now.
Hey,
going on? Where did they go?
They have pulled back to regroup for the final onslaught. It has been the highest honor. Halt! These are ours! Status report.
We just secured the main ports and transit points of Avernus. The Eastern Rebels' defenses are crumbling, and their Seeker support's falling back to the islands.
We've won, Commander.
This victory will not be complete until every last Seeker claw is torn from our world. We have much to do.
We have caught an enemy unprepared. It is an enemy, nonetheless, who outnumbers our fleet 2-1, who has superior weapons and hard fortifications. 3 wings of our fleet have trapped the remnants of the Seeker Armada in the skies above the main Seeker base on the island of Taran. The rest of the fleet is converging on this point. The Seekers see this base as the anchor to their rule over our world, and are confident that they can hold it indefinitely. We are about to prove otherwise. We rise from the water with the coming dawn and burn these demons from off our world in one fatal strike! The entirety of our fleet will strike at dawn as well and fill the air with such fire and noise as has not been seen on this world since its creation. Dawn approaches, brethren. Hone your blades.
This is Gideon. What's wrong?
Our dismantle teams have just discovered a massive self-destruct system. It is triggered to go off shortly. You must leave. Where can we leave you? Oi.
Typical.
We gotta go. We're pretty deep underground. Hope you brought your running
shoes.
What
are you talking about? We're standing on a landing platform. Cover me while I get this thing airborne.
Thank you.
You've gone local on me. I kind of like it. It's beautiful.
Is it going to be hard leaving so soon, Enorm? It seems as though we just arrived.
It is always difficult to leave my home, Exalted One. But the home I leave now is very different from the Aurelia I left to find you.
How so?
It is a place filled with hope. Never before have my people stood so united. The possibilities spread out before us seem limitless. We need to be down to the envoy vessel shortly, my friend, so I'd better go and make some final assignations. If you'll excuse me.
Did he really just call us friends?
I thought my translator had gone buggy.
I wonder what this Galactic Senate is going to be like. It seems like I'm still getting used to the strangeness of this world.
I don't know. Norm said that there are some races out there that even make the Seekers look tame.
Is it too late to change my flight?
Hey, come on, no worries, man. You happen to be traveling with someone who can shoot fire out of his hands.
Oh, Gideon. There's something I've been wanting to tell you.
Finally.
Well, you're not the only demigod on this flight.
The Senate recognizes Commander Enorum Tensper, envoy from the client world Aurelia.
Members of the Senate, I have come before you today with news that is both shocking and unavoidable. The Enkal have been carrying out a program of systematic genocide for eons against a race that is both defenseless and unaware. A race which has long been thought as nothing more than myth and superstition. This race, we know as human.
These charges are serious and damaging, envoy. You had better provide ample and undeniable proof of these heinous accusations.
Members of the Senate, I present to you a spokesman. The human Gideon Wyeth.
I am here to accuse the Seekers of destroying my world. I was witness to their bloody arrival on Edumea, their deliberate and directed murder of my fellow people, and the complete eradication of my...
This is simply unbelievable! These charges are preposterous! The Seekers are responsible for the sapiency of many of us in this very room!
I recommend that you use your vaunted sapiency, Senator, for this data is undeniable.
The Enkul have requested the floor, as is the right of the accused. Senator Mega, how do you wish to respond to this?
These ridiculous and obviously fabricated accusations are unworthy of a response, Your Honor.
The evidence is in front of us all, Senator. If you wish to debate its authenticity, then provide us with your counterproof. You and your race stand on the brink of being accused of the greatest crime in the history of civilization. I will ask you one more time, Senator.
Hello, brother.
Ethan.
This drama has gone on long enough. You look upon a true human, my children. The collective history, the countless religions, all bear witness to me. You know this to be true. The beauty of my divine form has been worshipfully rendered by your artists since time immemorial. This small, hairy thing which stands before you today is the pathetic remnant of an over-ambitious race, whose were too proud to worship me and my kind. It even dared to emulate our divine forms. This crude blasphemy is sacrilege. To warrant for us to allow, it will warn, it will command, but still these arrogant cruelties ignore our counsel. We concluded that only the most stringent actions could end this war. We enlisted faithful and called you after the herald Seekers, and commanded them to clean this arrogant race from off the face of our galaxy. We come here before you today. Solve them with any crimes. Have for another reason as well, my children. To return from the shadows of power. To retake our throne of stars. And to rule our scattered children once more. Rejoice, my children. For your gods have returned.
No! This is a lie! I have seen the true power of humanity! This creature intends to deceive us. No! Enorm!
You have the face of someone I once loved, but you are not him.
I tire of this. Give my regards to Oblivion.
Thank you.
me, human. There is much to be done.